Hello, welcome back to our channel, Fairy Inspirational Hub. You can subscribe, like, share, comment, and turn on your notification bell so that you will get updated.
This personality called the Holy Spirit is what I want to introduce to us tonight. Who is the Holy Spirit? Who exactly is the Holy Spirit? We must know who he is. Why is he so important that Jesus had to need him? Jesus walked upon the earth, never was able to do any serious kingdom thing until he came. Who is this personality so important that the saints of old, although they did not really know him, but they could not resist his influence in their lives? When he came upon them, they could not articulate. They never had a relationship with the Holy Spirit. They could not know who he was. They only related to him based on his influence upon them. There were only two people in the Old Testament who communicated such an appreciable dimension of intimacy with him. Number one was Samuel the prophet. Number two was David, the man after God's heart. These two personalities seem to have accessed deeper dimensions of their work with the Holy Spirit. A prophet that the Bible says his word did not fall to the ground. It was the psalmist that said, "Cast me not away from your presence." He said, "Take not your spirit from me." Who is the Holy Spirit? Now, let me tell you something. The Holy Spirit is not a bird. The Holy Spirit is not a dove. You have to believe this. The Holy Spirit is not candles with fire on it. The Holy Spirit is not anointing oil. The Holy Spirit is not water. The Holy Spirit is not wind. The Holy Spirit is not sound. All those things are similitudes of his operation. Similitudes of his operation, but not him. The Holy Spirit is not an influence. He's bigger than an influence. Who is the Holy Spirit? Number one, the Holy Spirit is God. The Holy Spirit is God. He is not like God. He is not a friend of God. He is not a mentee of God. The Holy Spirit is God. Every description that you give the Father, every description in terms of honor and acknowledgement and power and might, it suffices to communicate the same description to the Holy Spirit. Now, the difference of the Trinity is not the power and the might, but the system of their functions and their offices. It is based on that that we now classify the Father as number one, the Son, Jesus, as number two. Are we together? And the Holy Spirit as number three. The Holy Spirit is not junior God. The Holy Spirit is not the inferior part of God. He is God in every way, in every system, deserving of worship, deserving of honor, deserving of trust. So the Holy Spirit is God. Number two, the Holy Spirit represents the unlimited presence of Jesus. Benny Hinn calls him Jesus Unlimited. The Holy Spirit represents the unlimited presence of Jesus. When Jesus walked upon the earth, he was bound with a body. Listen, give us quickly, please, John chapter 14, verse 16 to 18. The Holy Spirit, a manifestation of the limitless presence of Jesus. So it is fair and scriptural to say the Holy Spirit is Jesus unlimited, without bounds. When Jesus walked upon the earth, he could not be everywhere at the same time. It is the Holy Spirit that makes it possible for every believer to receive Christ. He is the representation of the presence of Jesus on earth and in the heart and life of every believer. And I will pray the Father, this is Jesus speaking, and he will give you another comforter. You've heard the word, the Greek rendition is allos parakletos. Allos and heteros, these are words that mean one of the same kind or one of another kind. When you say allos, it means the same in quality and species, like the cat family. Are we together? The bird family. When you say heteros, it can mean many birds, but not of the same, maybe a dove and an eagle. They are not the same. So we have allos and we have heteros. Here it is allos parakletos, another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Next verse. Next verse, verse 17. Even the spirit of truth, whom the world, listen, Jesus is saying the world cannot receive him. Why? He says, because it seeth him not. So the first reason why the carnal man cannot walk with the Holy Spirit is why? Because he seeth him not. Now, Facebook and the social media has taught us that there is a possibility to relate with a personality you have never seen. Before Facebook came, they taught us something, I think in secondary school or primary, I don't know which one, pen pal. Something that you write letter and post to another stranger who replies you. But now with Facebook, you can communicate with a personality you do not even know. And from his expression, you can even know he is not happy. Yet you have never met him. The person is in Brazil, you are in Nigeria, and you are communicating, praying together, growing together, and you can even say, how are you, my good friend? The world does not see him, neither knoweth him. An encounter, not awareness. The world cannot have an encounter with him because he is not the way you encounter.